Hey, what's up? It's Taka here. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'd like to share how I implemented the two-factor authentication for Inkdrop. So today, I published version 5.11.0, which officially supports two-factor authentication. And so it's got a new UI for inputting time-based or one-time passcode here. I'd like to share which library I used and how I implemented this screen and so on. Let me talk about what's new in the version 5.11.0. So the second update is a big launch speed improvement for Windows. It took 70 seconds to start on Windows. That was terrible. I didn't know that because I'm usually on macOS. It turns out that Windows Defender took so long to scan the package files, and I've managed to improve the build process to reduce the number of files, and it significantly reduced the launch time to around 3 seconds, which is so cool. Well, thank you for helping me investigating this, Mika and Magnus and Lucas. Thank you so much. And this work also reduced the app size by 120 megabytes. So it's now around 420 megabytes. That's nice. And thanks for reporting, Shimizu-san, as always. I've fixed some UI issues. Yeah. So please download the latest version and try the new experience. I've wrote a guide on how to configure two-factor authentication here. This is on our documentation site here. So you can see the link in this release notes, so you can view it. You can learn the details. So it's simple, and I guess you don't have to read this guide. It's pretty simple. Yeah, so that's it. So I hope it works. Yeah, so please enjoy tech note-taking securely. Yeah. Okay, so let's talk about how I implemented time-based one-time passcode for two-factor authentication. So I've written a blog post about it. So I've implemented two-factor authentication manually instead of using other third-party authentication platforms like Auth0 here. So Auth0 provides an easy way to manage, identify, and access here. So I guess you don't usually need to implement two-factor authentication yourself. If you don't have end-to-end encryption requirement, so that's why I had to implement it myself. These platforms don't natively support end-to-end encryption. Inkdrop encrypts user data on user's client, on users' computers and devices. I can't see users' data if I have administrator permission. Yeah. So I need to implement it myself. So first I've researched open source libraries for supporting two-factor authentication. So first, I came across SpeakEasy. This looks the most popular choice to implement TOTP. But this is so old and it's no longer maintained, so I couldn't use it. And the next is OTP Lib. This is another one, but this is pretty old, unfortunately. And the node 2FA is also pretty old for some reason. And I've also checked some some articles on the web that used these libraries. And they are even published recently, but they didn't, they have never mentioned these last update date. But this is, maybe this is because it, these libraries are simple enough. So I need to, I needed to find alternatives that's still well maintained. And I came across this library, which is called Time to FA. So this is looks so active these days. Let's see. So yeah, it looks like this library has been constantly updated little by little. Yeah, this the library has been first published in 2023, and this is maintained by one of the hosting service company called Plant Hoster. And also I looked into the source code, and this, and it doesn't have any production dependencies, which is cool. And it is written in TypeScript. Yeah. And also the documentation looks looks adequate. So I decided to go with this library. And how to use it is pretty easy, pretty simple. So for example, you can generate a key, generate a TOTP key by calling generate key with some basic parameters, and you can get a key, something like this. This is pretty simple. And you can create a, you can generate a QR code from the generated URL. This is like this, OTP auth. So you can use it for displaying a QR code on the website. And this is an example to validate a passcode. So you have to store the secret here in your database. And with this secret and the test passcode, you can validate it if it's valid. Yeah. So I've used this API to support two-factor authentication and also generate backup code. Many websites support providing the backup codes just in case users lose their access to their second factor device. But supports to this time to FA also supports generating backup codes like here. But I didn't like that because this backup code is only a 6-digit numbers, which doesn't look so secure. So I decided to implement it myself. It generates the GitHub style backup codes, which is 10-digit alphanumeric characters. So I guess it's more secure. So you can copy and paste this function for your service. Yeah. And the next step is to implement a setup page. So I've used V0 to get some UI inspiration. And here is the prompt that I used, and it generated the first page like this. So let me show you. So here is the UI that V0 generated. It looks very simple, and I decided to use this idea, and it actually has some code like this. I requested V0 to use semantic UI, but it ignored my request, And instead, it uses Next.js and Tailwind CSS because they want people to use them. That makes sense, but I can't use this code snippet, so I decided to just use their UI ideas. And the next screen is the backup code, backup code page after generating the TOTP key. And so you can copy these calls or download the calls. So here is the So here is the actual UI, visual generated. So it looks straightforward. So I've implemented the UIs like so. And here is the backup calls page. So you can check out this project from my blog article. I put the link down below. So please check it out if you're interested. And the next step is to implement the login UI. And here is the UI mock from V0. And I've implemented it for the desktop app and the mobile app here. So yeah, so this is just a single input and the button. this looks pretty simple. So you can easily implement it without seeing any examples. The mobile one is I worked hard to implement this simple 6-digit input. So here is the mock. So let me try it. So it shows a 6-digit input. You can delete you can delete each digit. Yeah. So this is, it looks very smooth. And I've shared it on my Inkdrop note. You can see here. I've also put the link down below. So this is implemented with Restyle, which is one of the UI libraries for React Native. And I've implemented it to handle the each input for a digit. Yeah, so I hope it's helpful. Yeah, so that's how I implemented this two-factor authentication support. Yeah, I hope it's helpful. It was kind of hard to implement because the change range, because I had to update web interface and mobile interface, desktop interface, and also backend. Yeah. But I'm happy that I managed to finish implementing this feature. So yeah, so Inkdrop is now more secure. So please enjoy taking tech notes. That's it. So thank you for watching and have a productive day.